What we're going to do is we're going to show you how to take a steering wheel out of an airbag car. Let's face it, this steering wheel on our 05 Crown Vic is in pretty bad shape. The top of it kind of looks like the Smoky Mountains in a topographical map. Don't like the look of that at all, so we're going to fix that by going in and replacing it with another wheel that we got out of a cop car in a junkyard, because this is a cop car. So, without further ado, what I'm going to do is I'm going to send you over to Cam so Cam can show you how to make sure that you don't set off the airbag with, you know, any phantom power that may still be in the car. Take it away, Cam!
All right, so what you're going to want to do is take off your battery terminals. I've already pre-loosened these because I'm cool like that. And then what you want to do is once they're off the battery, touch them together, hold them together for about 15 seconds. All right, now what that has done is it has drained all the capacitors in the ECM, the SRS system, and everything for the airbag system. Now make sure that your battery terminals will not touch because that will charge the capacitors back up and add risk to you blowing up your airbag, which is not fun.
Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the airbag cover off. This has got your airbag and your horn system inside of here, so all this has gotta come out. And basically what you should have done is either done A, what we did, which is taken cross the battery cables, or taken your negative or positive battery cable off and let the car sit for about 30 minutes. I like expedience. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna show you how to take that airbag cover off, because it's not as simple as you might think, at least from an outside flush. You should look like you should be able to just pop it right off, but you can't. There are holes on the back side of this. There's four, two here on the bottom and two here on the top. And what you need is a 3 millimeter, just an Allen wrench or something that you can reach in here. And there's tabs that you kind of have to hunt around for inside of here. And I'm showing you on the one that we're gonna be installing, but there's tabs that you have to push in. You can see where I've got the pin, and we can push it to take that loose. And it's a push. I'm gonna show you on the backside what you're doing. You're actually pushing in this way with it rather than doing this. So you push that in and you move the tabs out of the way. Recommend doing the bottom two first and then doing the top two, just because the bottom two are a little easier to get to on the car. Then you're gonna have to swing the wheel back and forth to take the top two out. So I'm gonna do that on the car now. Can be a little bit of a hunt and peck. That one's done. Bottom one's out. Sometimes you won't be able to necessarily hear it when it lets go. Maybe let go is a bad word. Just reset the bottom two. All right, now. You undo the two bottom ones, you undo the two top ones, but sometimes when you undo the two bottom ones and you try to undo the top ones, the bottom ones will get loose again. So we went in and we actually used a little piece of wood to hold this out away from the column a little bit to get it where it'll come out. This one's ready to go, and we can pull it out. These two are your SRS supplemental restraint systems. This is your horn, and then that should be good to go. So we just need to unplug all this stuff and re-plug it into the new wheel when we start that thing in. Okay, these two come off of here. Now you'll note I'm pointing the airbag away from me, just in case. All right, set that aside, and now we need to take the center button out of here in order to facilitate removal of the wheel. This is all stuff for our cruise control on here. This is parts for the SRS, so that all will stay on here, and then we'll take all the rest of this out. Okay, now you're going to take a T50 to take this off. And I like using an impact because it's just a lot easier. All right, since it doesn't want to pop right off, some of them will, some of them won't. I'll try it one more time. Nope. Sometimes you can take and pop the wheel nut in the center, the loose nut in the middle. You can pop this with a hammer, and a lot of times it may let go. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna now try to knock this thing out by using a hammer. I'm gonna get my knees in behind it and pull, put pressure on it from back. And whack it with a hammer. And of course, that's not making any difference. All right, so we tried having big people pull on it and hit it with a hammer. I pulled on it, hit it with a hammer. nothing worked. So we're gonna go and do what you're supposed to do, which is to use a two-prong puller. We got this one from the guys at Harbor Freight. Nice to be able to just run down there now and grab one. There are two tabs on an offset on the steering wheel that you should tie into for the two-prong puller. This is the recommended method by the guys at Ford Motor Company. So I'm gonna go in and start tightening it up and get this to pull out, hopefully. There. I think that did it. You can get these pullers pretty cheaply at Harbor Freight. It's like $27 for a set of three. Shop cat. Yep, we're loose now. I'll pull this off. And there's only one position these wheels can sit in. So we're going to put our new wheel on. Now, this is the clock spring. You can actually, if you have a Crown Vic that doesn't have cruise control on it, you can add cruise control to the later ones, 05 on up, that I know of for sure, by just going ahead and getting the clock spring. For this car didn't have cruise control. All we did to add the cruise control was to put the correct clock spring in here. The only thing you will not get is a cruise control light on the dash panel. And just put everything back in position. All right, so that's this week's Manic Mechanic. Be sure to come back and watch us next time. There's no telling what we'll be jumping off into, but whatever it is, we'll show you how to do it in great detail. Oh, I don't have my Torx 50.